slant streets this morning. I heard the shots, wished it was just a warning blast.
Like to stand. Some people sit really low. Really tall people tend to want to sit higher and have the wheel higher because their legs are just longer. But now we're going to do the coning up. And this is where the clay platelet's going to be aligned in the counterclockwise spiral, because we're throwing counterclockwise because we're right hand.
Get it pretty wet.
You use both speed, power, and water when you cone up and bring it back down. So I squeeze the sides. And once the clay comes up between my hands, I move my hands up with the clay as I'm squeezing. It's a real balance between water and power and speed of the wheel. So, of course, the more speed you use, the more power you use, the more water you need. I'm feeling inadequate over here. Wait a minute.
I should have used more clay.
Some people will hold their thumbs. Some people, I usually just press my hands together like that. Kind of like a puppy. Right? The side of this hand is on the top. The heel of this hand is on the back. The sponge is held usually here. I line my pinky up in the center. The left hand pushes forward slightly. If you don't push forward slightly with your left hand, it's gonna mushroom like this. So what'll happen there is air will get trapped in there. So even though all you gotta do to fix that is just push forward and down. I mean, technically, if you just create a negative space with your hand, you should be able to center. This little thin thing come up like that. So if you see that, then you know, ooh, I got a gap between my hands. I'm screwing up. We'll just reintegrate that. So, yeah, once you've coned it up, then you want to push forward with the heel of your left hand and down with the side of your right hand. So it's a balance of power. Your hands are moving really slow, but your wheel's moving really fast. You want to always leave a gap under your left hand because you don't want to burn your wrist on the grog that could be in the clay, especially if you're using like raccoon clay. You also allow for a escape route for uneven clay by leaving a gap under that left hand where I can just scrape it off on the side like that. Another tip. So if I take my hands off really, really fast, it'll throw it off center. But if I ease off, it'll stay center. But really what we're doing is threading the clay up. So the outside hand's lower, the inside hand's higher. So it's kind of like a corkscrew. So by applying pressure in, and out, so in with my outside hand and out with my inside hand, and keeping them offset, I can move my hands up very slowly and it spirals the clay up.
Tore down the wall of fool around me, a reputation that I wanted to keep. City's mine. I cut my name into the steel concrete.
Stop my wheel unless it's an open bottom vessel. And then you're done. You take this and put it on your shelf.